All right, thank you everyone for joining. If you have a question for Karolina, please use the raise your hand function. Please state your name and your media outlet before your question. We'll do questions in English first, followed by any in Czech. To kick things off, Karolina, why don't you just walk us through the match and how you performed today?
I think I started not so well today, but as the match was going, of course, a bit maybe tired in the beginning because I had a lot of matches in the last couple days actually, and the conditions are not so easy, but I think I really improved my game, especially like end of the first set and of course the second set. I think I did some good job, good points there, good, much better serving than in the first set, and yeah, luckily I won in two sets today.
Please raise your hand if you have a question. All right, go ahead, Diana.
Hi, can you tell us how are you going to approach your next match?
The same way as I approach every match. Of course, I want to win. I want to try to do my best, to play the best tennis. And I mean, I know most of these girls I know. I mean, we played with Arina, we played in Wimbledon not many weeks ago. So I know what to expect. I know what I have to do to, you know, to beat her or at least to be close. So let's see if I can do that.
Do we have any more questions in English? All right, go ahead, Michelle.
Thank you. Hi, Karolina.
Hi.
As far as the match, I missed your early part, the comments you made to start the Zoom. What do you think happened that made you get to that streak where you won the last 10 games? Where was there a turning point in particular? Or did you repeat?
No, I mean, this kind of match, I knew it's going to be a lot about me, my mistakes and my winners. And just somehow, like, maybe like a couple of things, as I said, like maybe I was a bit like too tired. My footwork was not the best in the beginning of the match. I think I just missed too many easy balls. And I mean, she doesn't give you much, but also it's not like she would really like put a pressure on you from, you know, like that you have to make a winner every time. So I think I just rushed too much some of the points. And then I just like once I relaxed and I found a bit my timing on that court, I started to play much better, and I knew that, you know, like which kind of game I want to play to beat her.
If I may, for tomorrow's match, you beat Sabalenka at Wimbledon. Is she the same type of player on the grass as she is on hard court?
I mean, I suppose, you know, like, I don't think people really, really change a game, because once you have, like, this kind of game, I don't think you can go to something completely different just, you know, like, in a couple of weeks and or because it's different surface. We met on hard court, we met on grass. I think she's just, like, you know, smashing everything. I don't think there is a really a difference on the surface. Maybe, of course, on grass, maybe some balls are tougher to get. Maybe the serve, you know, is tougher to just block somehow because it's, like, faster. It's kind of stays slower. But also here, I feel like it's pretty fast. It's quite windy the last couple of days. So it can be, like, really tricky to just, like, you know, like, put back some of her balls. But, I mean, as I said, we played many times, so I know exactly what I have to do. Of course, the question is if I'm able to do it tomorrow. And how, you know, well she's going to play, because of course there are moments where she's playing amazing, you cannot do much about it. So, but I believe I will have some chances there.
Okay. Do we have any final questions in English? Please raise your hand. All right, we'll move over to Czech. Go ahead, Zindanek.
Thank you. Karolino, dobrý den, z nejlepší televize, nebo gratuluju.
Dobrý den.
Včera jste říkala, že Sáru vlastně moc neznáte a že nevíte, co od ní očekávat. Čím vás na začátku svojí hrou asi nejvíc překvapilo?
Mě asi nepřekvapila, protože tak nějak jakoby hrála to, co jsme čekali, nebo to, co jsem si tak nějak myslela. Samozřejmě asi oproti tomu, co jsem s ní hrála ty 3 roky zpátky, tak jako je víc solidnější, je vidět, že si víc věří, že má teďka jakoby letos nahraných spoustu zápasů a těžkých zápasů vyhraných, ale bylo to tak nějak spíš o mě, což jsem věděla, že bude hodně o mě, buď prostě budu dělat chyby a budu prohrávat, nebo prostě to nějak jakoby zvládnu, nedělat tolik chyb, dělat víc winnů a podaří se mi vyhrát, což naštěstí se pak povedlo vlastně od toho stavu 2-4, jsem se trošku tak jakoby uklidnila, trošku jsem zpřesnila a tam jakoby vodní nebyl žádný tlak, takže to bylo všechno jakoby jenom o mně, jak já zahraju.
Semifinále zítřejší a boj proti Sabalenko. Jak se na to vyrokovalo připravit, udržet si tu vaši 100% vítěznou semifinálovou letošní bilanci?
Tak je to další zápas, jakoby já to neberu jako semifinále, samozřejmě to je pěkný. Určitě to pomůže, že mám za sebou vyhraných teďka pár zápasů. Myslím si, že moje hra se jakoby každým tím zápasem trošičku zvedá, takže to pomůže. Na druhou stranu jakoby trošku taky únava je znát, protože ty podmínky jsou těžké a mám pocit, že jsem hrála strašně moc tenisu v posledních teďka dnech. Jsem ráda, že nakonec nemáme dneska už toho debla, protože to už by mě asi dodělalo. Ale jakoby soupeřku znám taky velmi dobře, hráli jsme s ní naposledy pár týdnů zpátky, takže asi tam není nic taky, co by mě překvapilo, ale samozřejmě tam oproti dnešnímu zápasu to bude, je velmi nebezpečná oproti té Sorribes, takže tam budou momenty, kdy prostě nebudu moc jakoby s tou hrou dělat nic, ale samozřejmě věřím, že mám zbraně na to, abych jí to znepříjemnila, mám dobrý servis, takže doufám, že to bude fungovat.